And thank you for being with us on Live at 9. In health news, there's a health hazard in Shelby County that thankfully is about to be corrected.
The county's hazardous waste policy does not include needles, and the large number of diabetics in the area means use insulin injectors are floating around. Health Department Director Alisa Haushalter and Jennifer Randle can explain how the health department is changing that. Ladies, welcome. Glad to have you both here this morning.
Thank you.
Having those needles out there, first and foremost, how dangerous, how much of a risk can this be?
It's clearly a risk because people dispose of them in their trash, and people may have access to those, whether it's adults going through trash or children or even those who pick up the trash and dispose it. So it does pose a risk.
Some people might say, and I mean, I was kind of like, well, insulin's not dangerous, but if someone has anything else and has used a needle, there could be, where is the hazard to that?
One, the needle stick in and of itself.
Gotcha.
But also there are things like hepatitis B or C that can be spread.
Gotcha.
By a needle. Mm.
Gotcha. And
yes.
This is not a part of the policy. How did you happen to notice this, Jennifer? We understand this was your kind of initiative.
Yeah, what brought this about?
Yes, simply a number of phone calls we received in the lab.
Oh.
So I guess about 2007 or so, people were calling and wondering how to safely dispose of their needles. Mm-hmm. And from that, the idea was born.
So with that in mind, what is the policy now? What does it state in so many words?
So now what we're doing is, in order to help that situation, is that we're providing containers where they can come and purchase and fill them up and return them. So therefore, you know, they don't have to worry about putting them in the trash.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Or, you know, throwing them out.
So these are two examples of the containers right here on the table in front of us.
That are safe.
Those are two example 1 gallon containers that, according to my research, that, you know, they can last for anywhere from a year to about a year.
Okay.
So you could only spend anywhere from $5 to $15 a year, depending on the size of syringe that you use.
And they need to get the container from the health department to make sure it's the right kind.
Yes, that's the thing. That you need to make sure it's the right kind of container.
Makes sense.
Yes.
And then when they come back to you, and we're going to put the address and where you go on the screen, when they come back to you, they can dump the needle. They don't have to buy another container, right?
They don't dump the needles.
You dump the needle, but they don't.
We don't dump
do
the
they
needles.
Keep the,
you don't dump the needles.
Oh, they
get locked
in there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then they're disposed of safely, so there's never a risk of anybody having a needle stick or any kind
Has this been tried any other place, or is Memphis, Shelby County kind of leading the way in this, as far as you know?
To our knowledge, we're leading the way for this type of disposal. Because this is for individuals who have prescribed use.
Right.
There are some places across the country where they do harm reduction for people who use street drugs.
Gotcha.
But this is quite a different program. This is for diabetics and individuals who use prescription or prescribed reasons for sharp.
What if there is some other reason to have a prescribed injection? Would I be able to participate and dispose of that needle in this program, or is this strictly for diabetics with insulin?
No, it's for anyone who has a prescribed use.
Okay.
So there might be individuals who are on IV therapy that have the sharp as well as tubing. There may be individuals that take injectable drugs because they have a clotting disorder. It's a variety
of there's a lot of different
medical reasons that an individual would have sharps at home, and any of those sharps can be placed in the container.
So is the policy again already in place, and how soon can people get their hands on these?
You want to answer that?
They can do it currently.
What we did was we
piloted for some months to see if there was an interest, and definitely there has been an interest.
Sure.
So people can come to the health department at 814 Jefferson. Most people are familiar with that building, and go up to our lab, which is room 258.
Okay.
And usually it'll be Jennifer or someone like Jennifer with a smile on their face that for $5 will give the box,
and then people
can bring it back when they're ready to dispose of it.
And that'll hold a lot of needles.
Yeah, we anticipate that may last people up to a year, but some people may need two a year.
You have simplified it for a lot of people, and also keeping the community safe at the same time.
Boy, I'll say, I hope there's an Employee of the Month program at the health department. Right there.
Get that. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies, very much.
Thank you so much for having us. We appreciate it.